Billing Encounters in TRAKnet 3.0. From the main menu, navigate to the billing dashboard on the left-hand side of your screen. Click the Encounters icon, the first function icon, on the list. You can search for encounters by using the search menu for patient last name, or you may search by date range. Select the date range that you would like to search, and then click Refresh. In the list that appears, you will see the note date, the patient's last and first name, the provider of the claim, the primary insurance, the balance of the claim, whether the claim has been charted, if the claim has been made bill ready, if the claim has been made patient responsible. To open an encounter, double-click on the encounter. The encounter opens to the Visit Note tab. Here you can see again the date of the encounter, the provider of the encounter, and the facility location the encounter took place in. The next tab is the Diagnosis tab. Here you are able to search for a diagnosis on the right-hand side using either the description or a code. You can add the code into today's problems by clicking the Add button on the right. You can add the code to your favorites list by clicking the Favorites button on the right. Favorites list can be created for yourself or for the practice. On the left-hand side of the screen, the bottom portion shows today's visit problems. You're able to remove visit problems by highlighting the diagnosis code and clicking the Remove button. You are able to reorder the diagnosis codes by highlighting a diagnosis and using the blue or red arrows on the right-hand side to change the order of the codes. On the top left, you will see the patient's current problem list. Problems can be made inactive or resolved using the Inactive and Resolved buttons. You can add a previous problem to today's problems by clicking the Add button next to the problem. Next, we click on the Invoice tab. Here you have four additional tabs: the invoice itself, the claim details, claim check, and claim history. On the Invoice tab, you'll have three different views in a drop-down menu. The current view is the charges view. Here you can see if diagnosis codes and modifiers are associated to a line item. You can see the quantity, the billed amount, if there are any payments on the encounter, and the balance by each line item. You can modify a line item by double-clicking on that item to open the treatment and modify mode. Here you are able to change quantity, change diagnosis codes related, or change modifiers. On the Claim Details tab, you are able to associate an ordering provider. This is also where the medication information is housed, and the 2400 ANSI loop notes are housed as well. Comment tab is where you can make comments on this particular line item. These comments are not submitted with your insurance with the claim. The next view is the charge edit mode. In edit mode, you are able to associate the diagnosis and modifiers directly on the line by either typing a diagnosis pointer, diagnosis 3, or by choosing from the drop-down list. You're able to choose modifiers by typing the modifier or by choosing from the drop-down list. Once you have made changes on a line, you'll want to click the Save button on the right-hand side, moving down to the next line and making any necessary changes, changing any modifiers, and clicking Save if appropriate. Moving down to the third line, making any adjustments. And clicking Save at the end of the line. The bottom portion of the screen, you're able to see the history for this patient. Using the drop-down arrows, you can select how far back you would like to see. Also in the bottom portion of the screen, the patient's primary, secondary, and tertiary insurances are displayed. You're able to change those insurances using the Change button on the right. Clicking the Change button brings you up a list of available insurances from the patient's chart. Highlight the insurance you wish to use and click OK. This will change the insurance for this encounter. You are also able to see if the patient has a copay on any of the insurances. If you wish to remove an insurance from an encounter, choose the Remove button. Moving over to the Claim Detail tab. Here you can select a referring and supervising provider, enter a date last seen if appropriate, choose a prior authorization from the drop-down. This is also where you'll enter any injury information, accident information, hospitalization information. At the top of the window, you can see the ANSI preview button, the CMS 1500 preview button, and the claim wizard. The claim wizard allows us to split the claim once it has been made bill ready to two different carriers. This is particularly appropriate for Medicare when a patient has durable medical equipment on the same claim as professional services. To use the Claim Wizard, once Bill Ready has been checked, click on the Claim Wizard button. On the left-hand side, your destinations are displayed, your format, the sequence, the place of service, and a checkbox for only showing unsent charges. Select the charges you wish to send to the appropriate carrier and click the Send button. You'll get a pop-up message that lets you know that the claim has been sent. This being a test database, I am not actually able to submit claims. Select the second destination, checkmark the appropriate claims, change any necessary place of service, and click Send. The remaining line items will be sent, and you can simply close the Claim Wizard. Since these items have been sent, I can just click Save and Close and be returned to the Encounter screen. You can see that my Bill Ready flag has now been turned green. Double-click on the next patient to scrub their claim. Click on the Diagnosis tab. Verify the diagnosis for today's diagnosis are in the correct order. Click on the Invoice tab. Change to Edit mode if necessary. Make any corrections to diagnosis and modifiers that is necessary. Making sure you click Save on the right-hand side. Next, click the Claim Details tab. Verify a referring provider, date last seen if necessary. Now click the Claim Check tab to verify there are no errors or warnings that warrant your looking into further. When ready, click the Bill Ready tab at the bottom, the Bill Ready checkbox at the bottom left corner. Then click Save and Close at the top right. Once your claims have been scrubbed, you'll proceed to the Claims queue. Clicking on the Claims queue, Here is your view menu with the drop-down arrow, selecting the unsent views. Clicking the refresh button will bring you the list of claims that are available to be submitted. You can filter by sequence using the drop-down arrow, selecting only the sequence that you wish to view, and then you can filter by output, selecting only the output you wish to view, and clicking refresh. In the list of claims below that is available to be sent for the output and sequence selected, use the select button at the far left to choose all of the claims or by output. Click the send button to submit those claims. Once your claims have been submitted, click the Gateway EDI icon at the top right of the screen to access Gateway EDI and verify that your claims have been received.